Glyburide is a sulfonylurea used in the treatment of non-insulin dependent diabetes mellitus. In this video, let's find found. What is glibenclamide? What is glibenclamide used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking glibenclamide? How does glibenclamide work? How to use glibenclamide? What is glibenclamide? Glibenclamide, also known as glyburide, is an antidiabetic medication used to treat type 2 diabetes. It is recommended that it be taken together with diet and exercise. It may be used with other antidiabetic medication. It is not recommended for use by itself in type 1 diabetes. It is taken by mouth. Glibenclamide was discovered in 1969 and approved for medical use in the United States in 1984. It is available as a generic medication. In 2022, it was the 200th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 2 million prescriptions. What is glibenclamide used for? Glyburide is indicated alone or as part of combination product with metformin, as an adjunct to diet and exercise, to improve glycemic control in adults with type 2 diabetes mellitus. Contraindication. Glibenclamide may be not recommended in those with G6PD deficiency, as it may cause acute hemolysis. Pregnancy and breastfeeding. It is generally not recommended during pregnancy, but can be used during breastfeeding. Side effects. Frequently reported side effects include nausea, heartburn, weight gain, and bloating. The medication is also a major cause of medication-induced hypoglycemia. The risk is greater than with other sulfonylureas. Pharmacodynamic. Glyburide is a second-generation sulfonylurea that stimulates insulin secretion through the closure of ATP-sensitive potassium channels on beta cells, raising intracellular potassium and calcium ion concentrations. Glibenclamide has a long duration of action as it is given once daily, and a wide therapeutic index as patients are started at doses as low as 0.5 mg, but that can increase as high as 10 mg or more. Patients taking glyburide should be cautioned regarding an increased risk of cardiovascular mortality as seen with tolbutamide, another sulfonylurea. Mechanism of action. Glyburide belongs to a class of drugs known as sulfonylureas. These drugs act by closing ATP-sensitive potassium channels on pancreatic beta cells. The ATP-sensitive potassium channels on beta cells are known as sulfonylurea receptor 1, SUR1. Under low glucose concentrations, SUR1 remains open, allowing for potassium ion efflux to create a -70 mV membrane potential. Normally, SUR1 closes in response to high glucose concentrations, the membrane potential of the cells becomes less negative, the cell depolarizes, voltage-gated calcium channels open, calcium ions enter the cell, and the increased intracellular calcium concentration stimulates the release of insulin-containing granules. Glyburide bypasses this process by forcing SUR1 closed and stimulating increased insulin secretion. Half-life. Elderly patients have a terminal elimination half-life of 4.0-13.4 H, while younger patients have a terminal elimination half-life of 4.0-13.9 H. Dose. Type 2 diabetes mellitus. Regular tablets. Initial, 2.5 to 5 mg POQ day. Maintenance, 1.25 to 20 mg POQ day or Q12HR. Not to exceed 20 mg per day. Consider administering Q12HR for doses greater than 10 mg per day. Micronized tablets. Initial, 1.5 to 3 mg POQ day. Maintenance, 0.75 to 12 mg POQ day. Not to exceed 12 mg per day. Patients at risk for hypoglycemia, 0.75 mg POQ day initially. Safety advice. Glyburide, also known as glibenclamide, is currently classified as Category C by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, FDA, for use in pregnancy. That's all the information about glibenclamide we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video, to update more health information.